tricky part. Let's see. Tricky, tricky. I think with this fabric, since it doesn't fray, I don't have to worry about putting anything on the edge. I don't think that's a big deal. I mean, I suppose I could if I wanted. Know if I want to. Let me figure a couple things out and I'll be right back. Okay, so these are or were the bag handles. So there was a seam up one side, so I took both bag handles and I ripped the stitches out and opened it up with my seam ripper. And then the only problem with that is you're going to be like finding little threads everywhere for a while. Okay, so then I'm going to fold it in half and find the half waypoint and like just again finger press it and give it a mark. And then I'm going to find this and find the halfway point on this edge. About there. I lost my mark already. I think it's right there, yeah. And then I'm going to wrap this around all the layers of fabric and sort of try to closely line up those middles. And the raw edges of all the fabric. Things are cattywampus a little bit because I didn't pin anything, so I gotta, that's a word, right? Cattywampus? All right, I'm gonna stick a pin here. I know I normally don't stick pins, but shocker, every now and then I do. Not that one, because that's dull. Duller than snot. Oh, that's better. So generally speaking, I like to keep quilter's pins rather than dressmaker's pins that are a little longer and a little sharper around the art room. Okay, so before I do any sewing, I'm going to make sure this is going to wrap around and be long enough, and it will. When it meets this other piece in the middle, I don't want to sew it to this. I want to leave a little bit of a slit there. So the first thing we're going to do is just sew this down. Ow! Ouch. Pins are sharp. Sew this down this edge, catching all the fabric in between the layers and this on both sides. You want to pin it, you want to hold it, and you want to sew in about an eighth to a quarter of an inch in from this edge, and that will ensure that you're catching everything you need to catch. I did switch my machine to black thread, so if I do make a mistake and my stitches aren't perfectly straight, they won't show too much. So there's a little tip. All right, that was sharp. Okay. I did also increase my stitch length because again, this machine is not really made for sewing all of this fabric, and it'll make it a little easier and it'll struggle a little less. When I approach where the pin is, then I'm gonna take the pin out. And I will have to just hold everything together. Threads. T- check the outside, make sure you caught everything you needed to catch. The stitching is not perfectly straight, but that's okay. I'm all right with it. It's less straight on the side I just did on camera than it was on the other side, but it's all right. I just want to make sure I caught all the fabric underneath, and I did. Okay. So now for the corners, I'm going to zoom in. Okay. So what I've done, what I've been doing is you want to take the corners and you want to fold the excess fabric in the corner as best you can so that you get a right angle. This is really tricky. I will be honest with you. This is not my favorite way to do edging on anything because I really hate fussing with this kind of thing. I don't have any patience. Y'all knew that already, right? Okay, so I'm going to sew a little bit and then I'm going to stop with the needle down and then I'm going to trim this back so these two pieces just kind of meet in the middle and they don't overlap at all. I don't want them to overlap. That'll make it too bulky and weird right here. You could do this a completely different way. Instead of putting a zipper on here, you of course could do it more like the traveler's notebook and just leave it open or put a Velcro strap or something like that. Oops. So I'm going to stop right now and I'm going to give this a trim. There we go. And as I get to the other piece, I'm going to overlap the stitching a little bit and go back and forth. All the threads. Check the outside. Make sure you've caught again everything that you need to catch. Do the other corner. There's a little bit of a Where are you? Right there. There's a little bit of a So, seam ripper. Let's fix that before we move on, shall we? So, we're going to take out some stitching along this edge, which I think I went back and forth, so makes it a little harder to get the stitching out. Okay. This side's fine, but right here somewhere it's all funked up. So we're going to have to fix it, so that I'm not going to be okay with. But now that I've done that corner, I don't want it to go too close to the corner, so and funked up, that's a word, right? Oh, I've got thread everywhere. Okay. Let's try that again, shall we? Let's. Okay. See, the problem with the Tim Holtz fabric is it's kind of a plasticky, vinyl-y fabric. So if you're going to put pins in it, you're going to leave holes in it. So you want to make sure the pins are in a place that you can live with the hole. This one's a little bit over the halfway mark. To do a couple of stitches just for the moment. Let's get this other side sewn down first. Okay. So now we'll restitch everything. The nice thing about using this fat sort of bias tape stuff, this edging, is that it covers up a lot of errors. So if you have some size errors, like I apparently do, it's going to cover them up. I told you guys this might work, it might not work. Didn't I say that? Alright, so we're going to start back up here along where the other stitching is. So I just trimmed a little piece off of here, so now it meets right to the halfway mark. That's perfect. Now we can do this other corner. I think I straightened all the issues out. I think I did. All right. So I'm going to do this other corner the same way I did the other one. Again, you don't have to fuss with something like this. If, like me, you aren't a fan of this kind of edging, because it's too fiddly. It does look good though. Take that pin out. I don't think we need it anymore. So before we get to the end, I'm going to stop, of course, with my needle down. I'm going to trim my new piece to just meet the other piece, like I did on the other side. Okay, trim all your threads. Take a minute, pull all your loose threads out. Shake it if you need to get some stuff off. So I do think you could zigzag around the edge to cover up or disguise any, you know, weird stitching that you have or anything. I don't know if I want to do that. If I want to do it, I have to do it now. I don't think I want to. I need my zipper though. So I would get a separating zipper, whether you get one with two zippers on it or one. You probably need a separating zipper. I think it'd be easier to put on. So I'm going to take one side off. Let's see. I have to fiddle with the zipper first and figure out how it goes together. I guess it goes that way. Yep. Okay, so you want to fold it in half. We want to mark the halfway point. I'm going to put a pin. Do the same thing to the other side. I'm not sure this is the right zipper for this, but it's the one I have, so. I like that it was black and chunky. So I'm gonna take my piece here and I'm gonna fold it in half this way and mark with a pin. I saw another thread. I did. Okay. So we want to line up. See, zipper pulls out. So we want to line up these two pins and then sew this around this way and around the other way. I'm going to unzip it. Zipper pulls out. Wait, I might have done that backwards. Hold on. I think I did do that backwards. Zipper pulls in. Yeah, because if I do it this way, yeah, that's the wrong way. Oops. Thank you. So zipper pulls in, right sides together. All right, I'm gonna start from the pin and work my way around and then do the same thing on the other side. We're gonna unzip the zipper now. So I'm gonna start here and work my way around to the split in the black edging and then start here and go the other way. And I'm gonna do that for both sides and I'll be back. Okay, we've got the zipper in and I did a couple things on the outside. And before I show you that, I wanna so we have some extra fabric here in the corner, and while I could leave it there and it'll zip up just fine, it'll be a little easier if I just snip off this extra fabric here at the corner. So I'm going to do that. You guys should see the floor in here. It's just a disaster now that I've been doing this. Okay. So now we have this nice big portfolio that we've made out of just things I had laying around the art room. And hopefully it will work for my travel bag. Got a pocket here, a pocket here, a pocket here, here, here. It's nice and big. And when it zips up, so I took the ends of the zippers and I could have hidden them on the inside, but I chose to just put a little tab on them and sew them down to the outside. Kind of like it. That's the trick. Does it fit in my art bag? No idea. Kind of looks like it might be too big, to be honest with you. It's a little bit big. I don't know. Let's get some stuff in it and let's see what happens. I like it in any case. You could use this for paper crafting, needleworking, you know, whatever you're going to do that you want to take with you. Reading glasses. Those are important. You should fit a journal in here. It's big enough. Yeah, and it fits. So there you go. I hope it gives you some idea of what you can do with something similar to make some sort of carry journal case or a planner. You could put a planner in there. You could put a lot of things in there. I don't know exactly what I'm going to use it for right now, but I do really like it. And if I want to use it in my travel bag, I can. That's it for today. Please like, share, and subscribe if you can, and support my channel by shopping in the Etsy shop. You can also go over and join one of my Facebook groups. The links for all of that are in the description below. The most important thing, of course, is go out and have a great day. Do something nice for yourself because you deserve it, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.